Have you ever asked yourself, how is it possible for some actors to make such incredible award-winning performances? Performances so powerful that create unique bonds between the character and the actors who plays them? If the answer is yes, then you should definitely watch Vittorio Gassman as Captain Fausto Consolo in Profumo di Donna. Io ti sentivo mia, soltanto mia. Soltanto mia.
As often happens, film of such potential and beauty end up being brought to the big screen through remakes, as in this case with the 1992 film Scent of a Woman, adapted by Bo Goldman from the novel Il Buio e il Miele, Darkness and Honey by Giovanni Arpino. In the role of the retired captain Fausto Consolo, we find the famous actor Al Pacino, ready to give us a revised and American version of our beloved Vittorio Gassman. And this will be the aim of our project, to analyze and show the actorly and stylistic differences of these two incredible stars, who have characterized two totally different cinematic worlds.
What can I say about Vittorio Gassman's Fausto Consolo? He's a scorbutic man who annoys anyone who has the bad luck of spending some time with him, except for most of the ladies that he met, who seems to be the only ones that can get along with the captain. He might be a gentleman, but he kinda refuses to be one, especially with the four girls in Naples, who know him since they were little, and considering that he harasses them in almost every sort of way, they kinda seem to be fine with that, even if we all know how wrong does that sound. His blindness seems to have led him into a twisted spiral of perversion. In one word, he's disturbing.
Unlike Gassman's Fausto Consolo, Al Pacino's Frank Slade proves to be notably different from the point of view of the attitude. Even if he represents the original character's curvy and relatively aggressive traits, he proves to be a gentleman who has a respectful relationship with women, who end up being fascinated by his elegant ways. The American character still has some disturbing traits, but they are most non-existent when they are compared to those of the Italian original one.
How does blindness affect Fausto? We don't know so much of him before the accident that happened. In fact, we only have a view on him thanks to a flashback of Sarah, the girl who is in love with him since she was little. But this flashback can be considered reliable, since Sarah idolizes the captain. Probably Fausto, since his terrible behavior is one of his most known features, was a perverted and annoying man even before the blindness. But his status quo, along with his fascinating charm, could have been some sort of breaks, which he loses once everything around him fades to black.
What we can understand through the film about the character of Frank before the blindness is a very vain and confident person who believes himself invincible, but then through a stupid game with a grenade in the army loses his sight and also all his credibility. This event will characterize Frank as an insecure man who uses violence as a shield not to show his weakness.
And now let's talk about Sarah. As I said before, she loves Fausto since she was little, not only for his beauty that Sarah remarks a lot, but also for how she treated her. Once he's blind, he tries to destroy all the expectations and thought that she built on him, because Fausto doesn't want Sarah to love him, even if he also does, because he does not want to be a burden for her life. We can see how Sarah may have a sort of do-gooder syndrome. She always puts Fausto's needs and problems right in front of hers. It seems like her happiness depends entirely on Fausto's, so every time Fausto refuses her, Sarah loses it, but always comes back to him, until the finale, where Fausto finally accepts her, even if that means ruining her life because of his needs.
In Scent of a Woman, we don't find a female figure that entirely recalls the role of Sarah in Profumo di Donna. Apparently, it might seem that the girl with whom Al Pacino performs the tango scene could be the American version of her, but Frank doesn't really have an emotional connection with this one, so I venture to bring a second hypothesis about the substitution of Sarah's role. If we analyze the kind of emotional bond between Frank and the boy Charlie, we can see how this has a significant impact on the unfolding of the entire film, but particularly in the final part, where thanks to him, Frank decides not to take his own life. This kind of bond is too strong to be overshadowed by the role of the girl who danced the tango with him, so I believe that in the American remake, the role of Sarah has been replaced by the one of Charlie. It must be taken in consideration, though, that Charlie, compared to Sarah, actually has the possibility to change the fate of the plot, whereas in Profumo di Donna, the role of Sarah, even if it's the most important after Fausto, doesn't really have this possibility.
What are women for Fausto? Women for Fausto are everything. He told Giovanni that it's not a problem for him to have lost the possibility of watching Sunset or St. Peter's Chapel, but the issue for him is not being able to look at women no more. He founds in the feminine body a getaway from his reality. When he's with a woman, and we can particularly see it when he goes with the prostitute in Genova, or with the escort at the club in Rome, he acts like a man with no such handicap as blindness. He laughs with them, he doesn't wear no sunglasses, nor he keeps anywhere near him his blind cane. With women who doesn't know him, unlike the girls in Naples, he wants to show the best side of him, and that's why he doesn't want to be seen in certain situations.
Although Gassman and Pacino play a character who approaches women in a totally different way, they both share an enormous passion for their bodies and their scent. In fact, even Frank believes that women are God's creation for excellence, and what their legs contain is heaven itself. They remain infatuated with him, but this infatuation seems almost pure, without containing anything sexual. We can say that Frank's attraction towards women is more ideal and sacred in comparison to Fausto's one.
In conclusion, we believe that these two films have at their base an almost totally different representation given by the social and cultural world to which they belong. In the first case, in Profumo di Donna, we can see how the military role of the captain for Fausto is not so relevant, while the role of the man in relation to women is the centrality of his character. The superiority of the figure of the man in comparison to that of the woman and the way in which the woman allows herself to be subdued by the man are a fundamental part of this film.
In contrast, in Scent of a Woman, the military role played by Frank and the references to American patriotism are an integral part not only of his character but also of his actions, from taking his own life wearing his uniform to the final speech of the film. Che mi riporta un poco del passato, che mi riporta un poco del tuo amore, che mi riporta un poco di te, un poco di te.